Hi, I'm Daria Fissoun, and in this video, we'll be taking a look at the CIE Plot tool in Nobe OmniScope. This information will be relevant among any number of applications that operate within RGB color spaces, but I'll also be focusing on the specifics of using this graph in the OmniScope interface. The CIE plot graph represents the 1931 chromaticity diagram developed by CIE. The horseshoe shape, known as the spectral locus line, is a quantitative map of the visible portion of the electromagnetic spectrum. Or, to put it more simply, it's all the colors we can perceive. Superimposed over this graph is a triangle that represents the red, green, and blue primaries of the color space that you're working in. Different display systems will have their own primaries, and they're able to reproduce chromaticity to varying degrees. We refer to this capacity for color as a gamut. Near the center of the triangle is a single dot representing the white point of that gamut. This is usually where the red, green, and blue values converge. D60 and D65 are examples of common display white point values. The white arc behind the white point is the black body temperature curve, also known as the Planckian locus line. It represents the color temperatures found in natural light. All right, now that we know what the plot represents, let's talk about how it can be used. When an image is loaded in your viewer, its contents will be distributed within the gamut triangle, representing the chromaticity values of that image. You can hold the Option or Alt modifier key to preview the trace distribution in the CIE plot. This readout allows you to check if your image is within the boundaries of the gamut relative to your delivery spec. In this case, we're seeing an image within the bounds of the Rec. 709 color space. Bear in mind that the CIE plot is just a 2D representation of the colors in your image, and it does not portray the luminance or altitude of those values. You can think of this graph as a slice of what is generally the widest part of the gamut in a 3D space. It's best to use this graph together with other diagnostic tools, like the 3D color cube, for a fuller representation of color intensity and saturation. In the CIE plot, if the colors are compressed against the borders of the triangle, there's a likelihood that the more vibrant or saturated colors in the image are distorted. If this happens, there are several things you can do to ensure a cleaner image. First, it's worth checking that your color management is correctly set up. If the input or output color space of your LUT, DCTL, ACES, or color management system is off, you'll likely see distortion in the luminance or chrominance of the footage, which can result in these types of oversaturated regions. If the compression is a result of your grade or creative LUT, then you can use the tools in your grading application to adjust the trace within the gamut triangle. For example, you can tweak the hue to reduce dominant colors, or the color temperature to move the trace along the black body temperature curve. Another option might be to reduce the saturation or color boost to bring down the intensities of the most vibrant colors. And finally, changing the luminance of the image, such as raising the lift, can also influence the trace in the plot. The tool or parameter that you need to use will be dependent on which tonal range of the image is impacted and your creative intention for the final look. By default, the gamut in the CIE plot reflects your working color space, which is automatically detected in OmniScope. You can see the name of the gamut in the upper right corner of the graph. To set your own working color space, go to the input settings of the Connect menu. If you disable the automatic color settings detection, you can use the presets underneath to quickly set up common SDR and HDR color spaces. You can also use the color management dropdowns to define specific color space standards. Right-click within the CIE plot to reveal the contextual menu. Here you can activate other gamut triangles to compare the image analysis across different standards, and disable colorize if you want a clearer view of the trace. As with the other scopes, you can interact with the source signal viewer for more refined image analysis. Drag in the viewer to isolate that section of the trace. Hold shift and drag to keep that selection in place until your next click. Open the settings for more advanced controls. Under the display tab, you can modify the appearance of the CIE readout. You already know colorize. Enabling Smooth Trace applies a low-pass filter with a gamma adjustment to produce a more detailed trace with easier readability. You can choose to show or hide graticule elements like the horseshoe, the grid, or the black body temperature curve. When working on an HDR master in Rec. 2020, but outputting to P3 D65 or Rec. 709, You can choose the gamut error check to see if your HDR signal is within the limits of the output gamut. If not, the values of the trace will be inverted outside the gamut triangle. Disable colorize and the out-of-bounds trace will turn red for even easier analysis. If the low-pass filter parameter is enabled in the input settings menu, then you'll be able to access it in the CIE plot settings. Activating the low-pass filter will remove some of the artifacts that can come as a result of chroma subsampling. This will result in a cleaner trace in the graph. Under the Overlays tab, you will once again have the ability to introduce additional gamut overlays into the graph, as well as the ability to define your own white point temperature and control the opacity of the gamut triangle. You can even add your own gamut overlay if you know its primaries values. Enable custom primaries and set the X and Y coordinates of the red, green, and blue primaries, as well as the white point. Thank you for watching this video on the CIE plot graph. Please remember to check out the video description to find the official documentation for more information. We hope to see you soon. Thank you to those that pressed the like button. You can subscribe to our channel for more training videos and future OmniScope announcements.